Hi there, I'm Zoot Java. Today I'd like to pay a tribute to Christie Blatchford. She died unfortunately from cancer at 68 years old. For those who don't know her, I'll do my best to paint a quick picture of her. Christie Blatchford was a journalist for close to half a century. In spite of the feminists of today citing her as being a nasty anti-feminist, Christie was an original feminist, where she blazed a trail that those who scorned her, I'm willing to bet, don't have half of the chutzpah that she possessed to get her through her life and her career, which also paved the way for her critics to waltz in and take advantage of all her hard work. After all, she had been a journalist, an actual journalist, at all of the Toronto daily newspapers. 1973, she became the first female sports columnist in Canada. 4 years later, she was a newswriter at the Toronto Star, then off to the Toronto Sun as a columnist in 1982 and the National Post in 1998. Not only an impressive career for a woman in journalism, but a career that anyone at all would be proud of. Her writing was quite often sympathetic to those getting the short end of the stick. Canadian veterans, Olympic athletes, and victims of crimes, particularly children. Christie Blatchford was born in Rouyn-Noranda, Quebec, winding up in Toronto during high school. She went to Ryerson University for journalism and was the leading journalism graduate. I stumbled across her column one day while working at a factory, and the only pages from the daily paper were left on the lunch table. I was bored and I began to read her column and was grabbed by her writing because of the way her style made me want to read it to the end, much the same way that an engrossing novel will gather up your attention. I began to look for her column every single day afterwards. I admired her standing by her convictions and not apologizing for her views. This is very important to me because you know where people stand that way. Many people, including myself, loved her through her writing, and many couldn't stand her. I find that that's when you were probably standing for something worthwhile. She was a climber, marathoner, lifeguard. She played basketball, took flying lessons. She doesn't really sound like any lightweight compared to the feminists who complained about her being a nasty anti-feminist. As she said, maybe she is kind of nasty. She apparently never got to write the one column on the one thing that took her from all of us. The funny side of cancer. Maybe I'll be able to put that together for her one day in her honor, as I just happen to be one of the lucky ones who was able to survive cancer. And while it is a horrible ordeal to go through, like everything else, it does have its funny side. Rest in peace, Christie Blatchford. You'll be missed by a lot more people than you could ever imagine. And now, even though this is a sad occasion, I'm still going to do my bad joke because I firmly believe Christie would have insisted on it. During the Canadian election, a lot of people only got a newspaper every other day. That way they didn't have to bother reading the denials and... Well, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications of more of my words of wisdom. Don't forget to share my content on all your social media because I tend to get suppressed by all the usual suspects. Until later, have a Java on Zoot.